Hello, hello, beautiful soul. Welcome to another short episode of Unapologetically Abundant Podcast. I'm your host, Petia Kolobova, and I am so blessed and grateful to be today with you. This beautiful sunny day in Las Vegas, and I'm just watching a blooming tree out of my window, and I so wish you could see it. It's so beautiful and enlivening and so rich. And today, I really want to be talking about richness, because I see that besides coming back to me, besides coming back to my worthiness, learning to have relationship with money was one of the biggest lessons I have ever learned. And I keep learning in my life, because when you look around, our life, it's all about relationship. When I ask you, most of you, what is your relationship with yourself? There will be sense of a relationship, right? You can tell, like, I'm feeling good about myself. I'm not feeling good about myself. I'm working on it. I'm on the process. When I ask you about your relationship with your parents, your kids, your loved ones, you can most probably give me an answer. It might be answer that it's uplifting. It might be answer that weighs you down, but yeah, there will be an answer. If I ask you, what's your relationship with money? Many of you will probably, first of all, not feeling your best. Very often talk about money. It's not like, oh, I'm so excited to talk about it. Let's talk about it. Not in many of you. And listen, I've been you. I was avoiding money. I didn't avoiding in a sense like, hey, Woody Cole, come here. I want to spend. I want to go to travel. I want to buy new clothes, new shoes. Treat my friends for an amazing gift or eating out. Like, I would be calling in the money for my own sake and pleasure, but it was one-way conversation. It was not relationship. It wasn't communication. It was just like, hey, now I need you, come here. Now I don't need you. I don't care about you. And if I ask you right now at this moment, let's like put our hand on heart. Let's be real and honest for a little bit. The way you're treating your money right now, would you like to be treated? Most often it's a no-no. And it took me years, heck, let's say decades, to create relationship and money and to really even realize that we get to have a relationship, because it doesn't feel good to me to be treating someone in a way that I don't want to be treated. I don't know about you, but I want to be treated with love and respect and understanding and acceptance. I don't need everybody to like me, yet I do want to be respected. I do want to be accepted for the way I am. I don't need the external validation anymore. I know who I am. I know what I stand for. I know why I'm here, and I'm living it. Yeah, the way we are treating money, it's very often, oh, I have to have it in my life. I have to pay my bills, or I want more of it. Yet, what is your true feeling and true relationship? Do you ever talk to money? Do you ever check up on it? Because when I started my own journey with money, let's go back a little bit. When I started my own relationship with myself, personal, spiritual development, it took me quite a time to establish a relationship with me, that it's not just inner critic talking to me and yelling at me out loud. And there were times that I just didn't feel safe in my life. I didn't feel safe in my own body. And that's what I was projected outside. And that's what I was attracting back. And then when I realized that how we all bloom when we are feeling loved and respected and treated with kindness, you know, it just sparked something in me. Because when I was reading the books, you know, and you will read them anywhere and everywhere, personal development, spiritual development, about, you know, money and abundance, very often people in books talk about money, it's energy. I'm like, okay, cool, I'm open to spirituality and all the woo-woo stuff, yet sometimes it's still challenging for my mind to like grasp, okay, it's just the energy, but well, it's in my bag and it's in my home and it's in my wallet. So how it can be just the energy? Is it like manifested energy? What is it like? So I didn't know how to treat energy, you know, because if I get to have a relationship, or even if you just think about it, forget the relationship for a second, track the money. Because when you say tracking, I'm like, oh, spreadsheets, get away from me, you know, or checking on your accounts and, you know, starting to have a relationship, it's acknowledging it and you get to know what's coming in, what's coming out. I used to live in like, okay, I get a paycheck and this is on my bank account. I have tons of credit cards. So, you know, like this is what I want now. This is what I want next. And I would not even know. Really, I was so blind that I didn't even know what exactly it's coming in. Like, oh, a few thousand dollars a month. Okay, cool. But I didn't know how much I'm investing out. How much am I circulating? How much am I putting out there? And I was spending money on things to make me feel better. And I was treating money as a thing. I don't know about you, but I don't want to be treated as a thing. So a couple of years ago, I started to work on my relationship with money because what I realized, I'm a hard worker, I'm a hustler, I know how to make money. That's not the challenge. I used to be working so hard that I would like work 7 days a week, 4 jobs, you know, I've been there, I've done that all. And it doesn't matter how much money I have made, for some reason, it felt like there is never enough. And it's because I had no relationship to it. But I want you, I'll spend you and bye, you know, and it's just, even when I say it now, it just doesn't feel good in my body. I don't want to be treated this way. So I'm not going to treat anyone that way. So what really helped me along my journey is to realize that money, it's not just the energy. We are all energy. Of course we are. Yet if I can, you know, imagine like a substance, like if I can imagine money, I started to imagine money like this beautiful gold goddess. It's a beautiful feminine energy. And that's how I see her. I treat her with a better feeling, better respect, better love, because I can imagine her. I close my eyes and I see her. I see her essence. So that really helped me not only say like, oh, it's energy. Okay, cool. But when I gave her the form, when I gave her the face, when I brought her in my life, I started to do money dates every single week to acknowledge her, to respect her, to celebrate her. Even when I pay my bills, when I'm sending, you know, when I'm paying invoices for my team or when I'm paying invoice for my mentor, I'm so happy and blessed that the money is going out because I am contributing to somebody's living. Doesn't matter how much or how little, you're always contributing to someone else's living. When you buy water, when you pay your gas bill or phone bill, when you invest in an online course, you are contributing to someone's livelihood and it's so beautiful. So really realizing that money, it's always there for us and with us and it's no stranger. And like a metaphor that I gave to one of my clients is that when we don't have a relationship with money, we are treating it like a stranger. So imagine you're sitting at a table with your family members. It's like this big gathering that you have your aunts and your uncles and cousins and mom and dad and grandma, grandpa, whoever is, you know, in your family, you're all sitting at a table. And then one of your family members is like, oh, let me just, we forgot something. I'll just run to the store. It's very important because it's like maybe the favorite cake of the family, or it's like, you need something for the mashed potatoes, whatever it is. But they say like, oh, let me just run to the store. I will take care of it. You're like, okay, sure, see you soon. You go back to the kitchen, you're doing your own thing. There is no doubt in your mind that this person is coming back with the thing that you truly need and you can live without for this party or gathering that is going on. So now let's flip it. And it's a complete stranger who attends your party and you never seen them before, you never talked with them before. It's complete stranger, it's not a family member. They come and you're like, oh my gosh, everybody's busy. Would you mind? And here is the money. Can you please like run to the store and get something that we truly, truly need? And they're like, sure. And they left. And you're like, oh my gosh, I didn't even take their number. Like, who is this even person? Like, I never seen them. It's a stranger. And you have this doubt inside of you. Are they going to come back? Should I send somebody else? So you're in this like fear because you're like, I don't know if I can trust them. Are they coming back? Are they going to bring it? So there is this insecurity, right? So now imagine money is this family member or money is this stranger. And that's how you're treating them. Because when you know that money, it's like your family, it's like your friend, it's like your lover, there is a trust, there is a respect, there is a flow, there is just this inner knowing. I know they love me. They will do the best that they can for me. I don't have to worry. I don't always have to see them, but I know they're always there. So start treating money as your family member and not as a complete stranger. Start treating money the way you want to be treated. Start having a relationship by even just acknowledging it. And what I do, I don't have it right here. I just put it back in the kitchen, but I have like a big calendar. It's a wall calendar where I write down all of the income and I highlight it. Like every day when I get money, it doesn't matter if it's from my online passive course, if it's from my one-on-one coaching clients, if it's unexpected checks coming in. However, whoever is the money coming in, I track it in a way that I put it on my calendar. It's there on the wall. Anytime that I see that highlighted numbers, and it's so uplifting and fun because I love colors. And then I have a big journal that is with the squares instead of lines. And that's where every month I have one page for personal investments, business investments, eating out, groceries, bills. So one page is for one thing. And every single week when I have my weekly money date, I write it down. What did I invest that in this week? I keep in the receipts, write it down. And then the most beautiful and fun part of my money date, it's really like a date. We make like cacao and I make snacks, like vegan cheeses, strawberries. I bake some muffins, whatever I feel like. Like every week is different, but there are snacks, there is drinks, there is Palo Santo, sage, crystal. So it's like fun. I turn off the world. And instead of like, I don't know about you, but tracking and just sit with the spreadsheets doesn't turn me on. I have my MBA. I was a bookkeeper, and it's just like, it sucks out the life of me when I just sit and track. Yet, when I make it fun, when I make it like a date, when I, have my essential oils and I have my candles and I sit with money and I have a music playing and I have a beautiful journal just for money. I'll show you like this beautiful leather journal just for money. And, I got it on the Bliss Project Life event with Lori Harder last year. I write down a letter to money, you know, like how appreciative I am with everything that I can do and how much fun we're having together and how blessed I am that I can invest in just organic food and drinks and, you know, my supplements. And I feel so amazing. And I thank the money. And listen, at the beginning, when I started to write, it was like more of like forgiveness than love letter, because I really acknowledge like, thank you so much for your patience with me when I abandon you, when I don't pay you attention, when I don't check up on you, how you're doing. And I never look at my bank account or my credit cards. I don't know what you need. I don't know how you feel. And so it was more like a forgiveness letter. But those are the three things that I do on my money dates. I journal with money. I write down the weekly abundance. Because when I write in my calendar, I write down, you know, the like the week totals, and then I write it in my journal, like the letter to money, and I say, thank you so much for this week abundance. And I write each item and how much was the total, and I celebrate it and I bask in it and I'm so blessed. And then I write down how do I circulate money and how I circulate money when I have even more. So this beautiful weekly ritual, it's just, it's so enlivening. I love doing it. It makes me feel good. It makes me feel uplifted. It makes me feel connected. And I can guarantee you that when you start having relationship with money, when you start acknowledging it and treating it the way you want to be treated, money will want to hang out with you. Money will want to spend more time with you and bring its friends. So it's so much fun to imagine money as a lover or friend or a family member, whoever like lights you up. For me, it's like this beautiful golden goddess. It's something in between like goddess and angel, and it's so beautiful. I know she's always by my side. And even when she leaves, I know she's coming back because we have a relationship and it's filled with trust and loyalty and love and acceptance. So ask yourself, love, what is your relationship with money and how can you start today just bettering it? Even if you just check on it more often, maybe if just you send her a mentally your blessing, that's such a beautiful, amazing start. Like, money, I bless you. I bless you and I hope you have a beautiful day. And that's it. Just start renewing the relationship and go deeper. And remember, I love you. I see you and I receive you. And I'm so excited to see what will come up with your relationship with money. Tag me on my Instagram at Petia Kolibova. Share in the Instagram stories this episode because we all get to create an amazing income so we can impact the world. And like always Chris Harder said, when good people make good money, we can do great things. So let's get doing great things together.